crazy.
Sounds like somebody's squeezing a duck in the background. Whack, 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 whack. Subscribe! No? Well, you can't blame a man for trying. What's up, guys? My name is Comedian. You're on my channel, which means what I says goes, and what I says is we're gonna be reacting to some more Anitta. Again! Ah, crazy! It's Anitta week. This time we're reacting to a brand new Anitta song called Fuego, which is also with DJ Snake, Sean Paul, who I've forgotten who that is, although it sounds like the name of, like, you know, some friend you would have in an English high school, and also featuring Tainy. It's kind of sad for him that those three artists got to be the main artist and he's just a featuring. I mean, is his part really that small? We'll see, I guess. And I want to thank a few of you for bringing it to my attention. So thank you to Mateus, Gislan Lopez Ferreira, PH Paulu Ham, and your old friend Osvaldo Lima, who outdid his personal best. Again, he left 5 requests for this song on different videos. I gotta admire the dedication, or your keyboard's broken enter key, whatever it is. Thank you for the request, guys. Obviously, I'm a big Anitta fan by this point, and it's a brand new Anitta song, and you guys know how I feel about chasing clout. So of course I'm gonna react to this Anitta song. It's basically as soon as I became aware of it. So yeah, that's all my bases covered. Legal documents signed, you are now locked in this contract, no refunds. Let's go! Whoa, it is starting off hot and heavy with some crazy video effects.
Don't make me crazy.
A very, very interesting vibe to start. Really interesting.
It won't take it.
Where did they film this?
I can find my DNA, loca.
Look at this stuff. Like, music videos these days, the editing just gets crazier and crazier. And it's interesting because, you know, I'll let you guys in a little secret. One of my dreams, apart from doing this with you guys and hanging out, is to eventually maybe, like, make music videos one day, or even have my own music video studio. But when I watch videos like this, with this level of crazy editing and colors and stuff, it makes me kind of want to sit down on the floor with a sandwich and cry for a bit. And eat the sandwich, but mostly cry. It just looks incredible.
Just one touch of me, give the little miss and she start to go loopy. Me tell her I'm loving her, miss Andy right back home, taking her room like she feel.
There is a lot on display here right now. Got a really big boomy beat, as you would expect from DJ Snake. I am a DJ Snake fan. Back in like 2013, when I was first getting into trap music, he was basically putting out all the trap bangers, so shout out to Mr. Snakey Snakes. But yeah, lots on display here. The big boom beats, crazy video effects, some cool rapping, and Anitta's booty. So far we're off to a great start.
And I must love the way out, she just can't leave me alone. Crazy because she a pick up the phone, she not stop cause she moan, and I tell her she moan and groan on his own.
I don't know if my brain can handle this many lyrics being thrown at it at once. I'm like barely hanging on. I feel like I'm like on the edge of a cliff. My brain is on the edge of a cliff, hanging on by one brain tendon. And this man, who I think is Sean Paul, the rapper, he's just spitting words on me. Words after words, and I'm like, help, help me. That was a very labored metaphor, but my point is, it's a lot of words. So yeah.
Wrong, give me the crown.
Something about this Ring of Fire has given me very strong flat-out Ultimate Carnage vibes. I don't know if you guys ever played that game, it's quite an obscure and weird reference, but if you did, then thumbs up, because that probably means a lot to you. For the rest of you, which is like 99%, it means nothing, and I apologize. The imagery is insane, honestly. I actually can't get over this. Like, it's not just the fact they're standing in this like crazy pool of water, they're wearing like these weird like neon wigs, and the side shot especially, it just looks, I don't even know how they film this. Like, where do you film this kind of thing? Did they just like invade a public park, one of those like, you know, little kids paddling pools, and put up some like black cloth and kick the kids out and then just set everything on fire? Somewhere out there, there's a public park with a ring of fire burnt around the kids' pool, and these guys are to blame. Was that line, "Don't make me crazy, your bed won't take it"? Whew! That's a strong lyric. Anitta, this is the second Anitta song I listened to with, like, you know, quite a lot of English lyrics. And that is a heavy lyric. That's good. That's, that's almost a threat. I wish I could make my nipples dance just by clenching them. This is one of those songs that begs for you to be able to make your pecs dance. What is that supposed to be? As like, is that a chorus? It sounds like a friend who got lost in the basement calling for help. Like, you just hear a distant like, Barry? Barry, where are you, mate? Where are you? I understood the words mouth and clothes, which could be sexual, or it could just be like an advert for like Gap or something. So who knows? I would not want to be whoever had to do the coordination for this thing. The choreography. Like, whew! My lord. I don't know if they really should have got Sean Paul on the chorus. I mean, it just doesn't really fit. Sounds like somebody's squeezing a duck in the background. Whack, 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 whack. You don't know anything about my bed, Anitta. My bed is fierce. Got that memory foam. It's like 5 feet off the ground. Concrete pillars on it. Bomb shelter. What am I talking about? I can't get over this chorus. It's just something that, maybe it's good, maybe it's catchy, maybe that's why my brain keeps fixating on it. It sounds like Sean Paul was singing normally when somebody ran up to him and shoved a pan pipe down his throat. Now it's lodged in there and he's like, it's very strange. I mean, it has to be a computer effect, but it's very strange. But again, I'm fixating on it, so that's probably by design. That probably means it worked. I just wish I knew what the singing was.
Don't make me crazy.
Look at that outfit. If you look at how this combines with the image of like the flames and stuff, like this costume design is on point. Honestly, that's genius.
Crazy. Your bed won't take it. Don't start that fuego. I can find my DNA. Loca.
What is it with music companies ruining their, you know, these music videos probably cost a fortune to make. I mean, they are like really, you know, well done, and it's really quite a beautiful piece of cinematography, really. And I know I sound angry here, but it's annoying to me that they've covered it with an end screen. Hello, an end screen is supposed to be what happens after video. Imagine how annoying it would be if I started my end screen on the outro. Well, actually, that probably wouldn't be annoying, because that would probably be like a relief for some of you. But think of a YouTuber that you actually genuinely like. Imagine if they were still talking and then the end screen comes up as they're still talking. It's distracting, and this is what is on a much bigger scale. If you're watching music video producers for famous artists who spend lots of money, put a 20-second black screen at the end of the video. It isn't hard. Everyone else manages it. The whole ending, which presumably people spent hours filming and writing and running out to get, you know, water and porta potties for the crew for, and all that stuff, is covered with this crap. Okay, well, you know, grievances about, you know, the outro being smothered by ads for more videos and stuff, that was really fascinating. And I'm using the word fascinating because I think the video was incredible. In fact, I actually preferred the video over the song. And again, this is just me, but like, I'm the kind of person, if I see a name like DJ Snake in a song, I expect it to have, like, some quite decent EDM leanings. Like, basically, once it starts playing, I want to be able to be like, okay, yeah, that is definitely DJ Snake. I can hear that. And I find this problem a lot with a lot of Skrillex's productions, because Skrillex has a lot of productions for pop artists these days. And you listen to it, and you're like, well, it's really good production, obviously, but it could be anyone. Like, it's disappointing when you don't hear their stamp on it. So the fact that this song didn't turn into a head-stomping trap banger halfway through has made me judge it a little bit, but the video itself I thought was incredible. Like the cinematography, the visuals, like even, you know, the costumes, like it was really like a quite intense dash of color and mood. Really, one thing I'll say about the song is it's got a really heavy mood, and I'm all about that. So thank you for suggesting that. Hope you guys enjoyed my reaction. Please subscribe if you haven't already. I got more Anitta reactions coming out, or more DJ Snake reactions. I'll do Sean Paul reactions. I'll even do Tainy reactions, even though I'm not quite sure who Tainy was in that video, but whoever they were, point them out to me and I'll react to more of their stuff if that's what you're into. I just want to make you guys happy, because making you guys happy makes me happy, because it makes me think that one day I might actually make some money. So yes, thank you so much for watching. Please like, please comment, please post pictures of your favorite fast food meal in the comments. And remember, if you understood the chorus by Sean Paul, then click the subscribe button, you fool.